Cooking Taosho Buddha way, cooking lovingly and meditatively. Your body is the temple. Treat your body gracefully and wisely.
Listeners on Radio Akashwani 106.5 FM and on World Wide Web, Know Your Food, a program to educate you about whole wheat flour, coconut oil, salt, spices, and all that you need to know about food. Remember, each word and each sentence is a musical composition. Also, it has its own soul, mind, and body. This trinity together creates energy field. The food that you eat, the contents, the ingredients, and the processing method, all these form the trinity of health. And you have to know how to harness this. Very often we have heard people speak about lifestyle, change in lifestyle. What do you understand by this word lifestyle change? Does it mean wearing a brand name shirt or a branded t-shirt in place of an ordinary t-shirt? Wearing the brand name sneakers, walking with the latest model of iPhone, and sitting driving a Audi, Mercedes-Benz or BMW? Do you think sitting in Mercedes-Benz your cardiovascular symptoms are removed or your diabetes is removed? This is what we call ourselves, what we understand by lifestyle change. Lifestyle change really means that you are bringing an inner change, a change in your innerness, change in your inner habits, change in your food habits. You will complain that the coconut oil is very expensive, the stone grind whole wheat flour is very expensive. But I have not heard anybody complaining that the sneakers price is very high as compared to the ordinary sneakers. Ordinary phone you may get for $100, but iPhone in thousands. Ordinary car you might get for 100,000 or buy a foreign used even cheaper. But BMW, the latest model, that stands as a symbol of your lifestyle, cost so much and nobody complains. But as compared to a $20 flower to $80 flower, there are many complaints raised. So I wonder sometimes, are you really concerned about your health or it is not so? You should be concerned about what kind of food you are bringing into your stomach. Remember, your body is the temple. I keep on reminding you, your body is the temple. You can only bring things which are beneficial to the temple building. Of course, we are coming to you with the compliments of Swarna and Deep whole wheat, chakki atta, stone grind flour, Deep multigrain flour, Surabhi and Lakshmi coconut oil, Shri Gun masalas, and Himalayan rock salt. I was speaking to you about the coconut oil, the research of Dr. Mercola. The truth about coconut oil is obvious to anyone who has studied the health of those who live in native tropical cultures, where coconut has been a primary dietary staple for thousands of years. Back in 1930, Dr. Weston Price found South Pacific Islanders whose diets were high in coconut to be healthy and trim despite high dietary fat, and heart diseases were virtually non-existent. Similarly, in 1981, researchers studying the Polynesian communities for whom coconut has been the primary caloric energy source found them to have excellent cardiovascular health and fitness. But it has been propagated, advertised that coconut oil is not good. But Where were all the clogged arteries and heart attacks from those who were eating this evil saturated fat as it has been propagated? Obviously, coconut oil was doing nothing to harm the health of these islanders. It may be surprising for you to learn that the naturally occurring saturated fat in coconut oil is actually good for you and provides a number of profound health benefits, such as improves your heart health, boosts your thyroid, increases your metabolism, promoting a clean body and weight loss if needed, supports your immune system. Coconut oil even benefits your skin when applied topically and has been found to have anti-aging regenerative effects. So what are coconut oil's secret to success and how coconut oil works wonders in your body? Nearly 50% fat of coconut oil is a type rarely found in nature called lauric acid. This is a miracle compound because of its unique health promoting properties. Your body converts lauric acid into monolaurine, which has antiviral, antibacterial, and anti-protozoa properties. Coconut oil is also nature's richest source of medium-chain fatty acids, also called as medium-chain triglycerides or MCTs. By contrast, most common vegetable or seed oil are composed of long-chain fatty acids, also known as long-chain triglycerides. Long-chain triglycerides are larger molecules, so they are difficult for your body to break down into smaller ones and are predominantly stored as fat in your body. It clogs your arteries and it remains deposited. But medium chain triglycerides, being smaller, are easily digested and immediately burned by your liver for energy, like carbohydrate, but without the insulin spike. When you use coconut oil, there is no spike nor rise into your insulin level. Medium chain triglycerides actually boost your metabolism and help your body use fat for energy as opposed to storing it, so it can actually help you become slimmer. Let me pause for a moment and tell you something. I use coconut oil in everything that I cook. And not only that, a big mouth bottle, I keep it in the fridge, and every morning I dig out a stick of coconut oil, which is frozen, and use it as white chocolate. It's a very tasty and it has a sweetened taste just like coconut. And besides that, what it is very good, it is good for your body. And when you switch over to coconut oil, your lifestyle changes beautifully and beneficially for your own sake. So, why not switch over to coconut oil? Surabhi coconut oil is available at Naipaul's Extra Food 3 branches. You can call 662-8151 for Grand Bazaar, and also at Prem Singh's Puja Bhavan, 663-2494. Other numbers where it is available, I'll give you at the end. Now let me speak something about the deep multigrain flour. But before that, let me give you good news. Soon you will be getting deep frozen foods, deep samosa, cocktail size, very small, like finger foods that you can use for your cocktails, parties, while the guests are waiting for the main course meal. This can be served as finger foods. Then party samosas, paneer and spinach samosas, chicken samosas, and of course, long awaited plain naan, garlic naan, paneer paratha and aloo paratha will also be available at selected stores. So multigrain flour means you are making your whole wheat flour, which is a strewn grind, already naturally good and healthy, because it contains wheat germ, wheat bran and all that is natural. You do not need to add baking powder to rise the roti like a balloon. Just knead with the water, consistency according to your liking, soft, medium or hard, and make your balloon like swelled up rotis. And when I am talking about multigrain, that means different grains are added to it to make it multigrain and more nutritious. Teep multigrain flour, which comes in 4-pound packing, it has chickpeas flour, which is chana flour, soybean flour, barley flour, corn flour and sorghum flour. All these flours are rich in protein and they are gluten free, so they reduce to some extent the gluten content of the whole wheat flour. Enough on flour, but keep on listening, because all that I have known and all that I have researched is not finished yet, and I am giving you bit by bit so that your mind can absorb. If I put out everything, you will not be able to absorb or understand. Now let me speak to you the dangers of common salt. To refine common salt, chemicals are used. As a result, after the salt is chemically cleaned, there remains only sodium chloride. This is unnatural chemical form of salt that your body recognizes as something completely foreign. This form of salt is almost every preserved food that you eat has. Therefore, when you add more salt to your already salted food, your body receives more salt than it can dispose of. It is important to note that over 90% of the money that people spend on food is for processed food. Typical table salt crystals are totally isolated from one another. They are not joined together. In order for your body to try to metabolize table salt crystals, it must sacrifice tremendous amount of energy. Inorganic sodium chloride can keep you from an ideal fluid balance and can overburden your illumination system. When your body tries to isolate the excess salt, you are typically exposed to water molecules that surround the sodium chloride to break up into sodium and chloride ions in order to help your body neutralize them. First, it has to break into sodium and chloride, only then your body can neutralize them. To accomplish this, water is taken from your cells in order to neutralize the unnatural sodium chloride. What happens to this? This process causes a less than ideal fluid balance in the cells. In the process, you lose precious intracellular water when you eat normal table salt. For every gram of sodium chloride that your body cannot get rid of, your body uses 23 times the amount of cell water to neutralize the salt. Regular consumption of common salt causes excess fluid in your body tissues, which can contribute to unsightly cellulite, rheumatism, arthritis and gout, kidney and gallbladder stones. When you consider that average person consumes 4,000 to 6,000 milligrams of salt per day, and those who are heavy salt eaters, they consume nearly 10,000 milligrams of salt per day. That means 10 grams of salt. It is clear that this is a serious and pervasive issue. Ponder over these statistics and think over it. When you are eating outside or the processed food, you have to consume the table salt. But you can make a lifestyle change. At home, use Himalayan rock salt that is sold in the market as fire salt, which has 95% Himalayan rock salt and 5% cayenne pepper. Both are good for your cardiovascular health. And also there is another salt, black fire salt, where 95% of rock salt is mixed with 5% of black pepper. Both are naturally good and hygienic for you. For any information on these products or wholesale inquiries, you can call me at 683-8587. Himalayan rock salt as fire salt is available at Prem Singh's Puja Bhavan, Curep and Shagwanas. Now let me speak to you about masalas. There are certain basic spices. First of all, what is difference between a spice and herb? You look at a plant, it has three parts of it: the leaves, number two the stem, and number three the roots. The leaves are called the herbal part of the plant. You can get fresh herbs or you can get dried herbs. The stem and the roots and the flowers, that when it is dried, it becomes seed. So the seed of the plant, the stem, as well as the roots form the spice. For instance, the seed of the coriander plant is known as dried coriander powder, coriander. Now the fresh leaves is known as coriander leaves, that has a very fragrant smell, very nice, pleasant smell. And then there are plants whose stem is used, like cinnamon. The nutmeg is the fruit, and the outer covering of nutmeg is known as mace. Both are equally important for your health. Now there are certain roots like turmeric. It has to be dried at a certain temperature in order to get the correct color. Ginger, another root spice. So when you are blending your spices, there has to be a blend of basic spices, which is coriander, turmeric and your chili powder. But in addition to that, these aromatic spices are very important, but these are used in trace elements. Now when biryani is made, it was introduced during the Mughal Empire by the queen of King Jahangir, Noor Jahan, to introduce a complete meal for soldiers, so that many things have not to be made. So it has the rice as a staple food, and of course we are bringing deep basmati rice, which is nourished by snow-fed mountain rivers, and it is cured to give a fragrance. It is very light and very tasty rice. So when the biryani was made, it was made with rice as a staple food, chicken or lamb or any kind of meat, because it was to be given to the soldiers, and it uses a combination of 32 spices. Why 32 spices, not one? Because you remember, the moment the process of digestion begins, your body releases 6 juices. If any one of these is not consumed, it remains deposited in your system. You look at your popular street food, doubles. Does it have any taste if pepper is not added to it? Pepper kills your taste buds. And not only that, the kind of pepper that we use, it burns your stomach and gives you ulcerated stomach. As compared to that, green chilies or chilies. And then the best of this is cayenne pepper, which is helpful in cardiovascular health. So when these masalas are mixed in a proper blend, it gives you a taste, it gives you a nourishment, it gives you a health, and you feel satiated by eating a small quantity of the food. So for that very reason, when we introduce for the first time Shri Guna spices manufactured in New Delhi, I was told my brother that I should meet the owner. I said, no, I don't need to meet the owner because I have tasted his product. And the product, the masala combination, the mixture that he has made, that speaks of his thorough knowledge, understanding of his spices, and the principle of blending these. So when we take biryani pulao masala, it is a combination of different herbs and spices, aromatic and basic. And then there is a long list of masalas for each product. Chicken and duck masala, shahi paneer masala, butter paneer masala, fish curry powder, the shrimps masala, the lamb and goat known as meat masala. Then there is the garam masala, and also soon we are introducing tea masala. When you have a sweet tooth and you want to eat sweets, then you should take after that a masala tea which has cinnamon, and that is an antidote for sugar. So all these masalas, and we bring a herb called methi. It is dried methi leaves, very fragrant. When you add to your common day-to-day vegetables, it not only adds the nutritional value, but it gives a very pleasant, loving taste to your vegetables when you cook this. And no East Indian restaurant cooks anything without the fragrance of methi leaves. Very important ingredients. We are coming to you with the compliments of Shri Gun blend of spices, the dal makhani masala, biryani masala, sambar masala. Sambar is a specific blend of dal which is rich in vitamins, minerals and fresh vegetables, or blended into it to make it a very tasty tani. It has a bitter taste, it has salt taste, it has little taste of sourness, and it has all the spices, mustard seeds and many other spices are blended into it to make a very tasty and savory dal. You can go to my website Cooking Taosho Buddha Way, Volume 1 and Volume 2. You just Google these names, Cooking Taosho Buddha Way, Volume 1 and Volume 2. You will get a lot of recipes. But you remember, these books are available for sale, so you cannot download. You can simply read as much as you want. You can note down all the information that is contained in that about the particular recipe. Of course, we are coming to you with the compliments of Deep and Swarna whole wheat flour that comes in 4-pound, 10-pound and 20-pound packing. Multigrain flour, 4-pound packing. Buckwheat flour, sorghum flour, moong dal flour, besan, Surabhi and Lakshmi coconut oil. Of course, today I didn't speak about ghee. Probably next week I'll speak. So Deep ghee and Nanak ghee and Himalayan rock salt. These products are available at Naipaul's Extra Food. Grand Bazaar carries a large variety. The other branches carry selected. Prem Singh's Puja Bhavan carries the widest range. Vishnu 337-3785 in Pinal Market. And Sukhraj Bhagwan Deen, popularly known as Fat Man, 377-0583 in Debe. And in case you need to put these products on your supermarket shelves, you can call me at 683-8587 for all your inquiries, wholesale inquiries, and any other thing you want to know about these products, you can let me know. And I'll be too happy to give you the information. Remember, health is in your hand. Your body is the temple. Treat it lovingly and wisely. Only then you can live the right allocated life that is given to you. Only this much for this morning. Do have a pleasant day and take care of your foods and body. This is Taosho Buddha signing off. 683-8587.
Cooking Taosho Buddha. Cooking lovingly and meditatively.